patient. And thirdly, my presentation is factual. It's not an opinion and is based on the debate actually in France and what are the arguments the Ministry of Health use to take a decision about mandatory and recommended immunization. After Prime Minister on July 5th, Professor Agnès Buzyn, Minister of Health, has announced on July 11th that from 2018, children under 2 years of age must be vaccinated against 11 diseases. So I translate the press release on this dia. You could read the rationale of the decision. What is the context? In France, we have a coexistence of mandatory and recommended vaccination in the French vaccination schedule, and it's difficult to explain and to understand both for population and both for the health professionals, especially for doctors. Mandatory vaccine are not available alone, which is being contested by the anti-vaccine movement. And in addition, there is a debate on the adjuvant, aluminium adjuvant, which is present in the vaccine. So it's a movement of contestation about this mandatory vaccine. Recommended vaccine are considered as optional and not recommended, even if the recommendation is such important that the mandatory vaccine. Vaccine coverage is very high for mandatory vaccinations and combined vaccine, but not enough to other recommended vaccine, especially for MMR. Distrust between population and healthcare worker is increasing for several years. Here is the vaccinal schedule, and you can see in green that diphtheria, tetanus, poliomyelitis, which are the mandatory vaccines, are always associated with pertussis and hemophilus influenzae B in the Canta vaccine, or with hepatitis B in the Hexa vaccine. Here you have the situation for the different vaccine and vaccine coverage. And for DTP, DT polio, obligations are historical after epidemics in France. The last mandatory immunization is polio in 1964, which stopped the epidemic. And from 1966, for pertussis vaccine, health authorities considered that it was better to promote health education and to recommend immunization and to con- in order individual could be concerned by his own immunization. So other immunizations are only recommended for the general population. You could see that for mandatory immunization, the coverage rate at 2 years old is very high. And also for the combined vaccine, pneumococcus, either if it is alone, the coverage is high, but for MMR and in France is ROR, is still not so high, and we have still a cluster of epidemics running in different parts of France because the coverage is suboptimal. And for meningococcus, the rate vaccine coverage is 70% and is in progression. Distrust and vaccine hesitancy is increasing among the general population, especially from 2009, after the pandemic flu vaccination campaign failure, where many people discovered the discussion and the polemics on vaccination on the networks. And the anti-movement vaccines use this way to promote their discourse. You see that in 2016, the last survey, the 25% are unfavorable to vaccination. That doesn't mean that they are unfavorable to all vaccination. They have a selective opinion, and people are mostly unfavorable to three vaccines: flu, hepatitis B, and HPV. However, even if in 2016, the rate of unfavorable for DPT and MMR is very low. There is a significant increasing between 2014 and 2016, and that is a preoccupation. Perception of vaccination according to the region is different, with a lower favorable rate in the south of France. And vaccine coverage is also lower in the same regions of the south of France. And this region is especially the most of the anti-vaccine movement are located in this region, and especially in near Annecy or in Savoie. most of the GPs have a very favorable attitude toward vaccination. But in fact, they could be hesitant for some vaccination and don't feel comfortable explaining side effects or answering questions about some vaccine, and especially about adjuvant additives in the vaccine. They are very uncomfortable about that, and they prefer to avoid discussion on vaccination. And when they feel that people could ask a question and be hesitant, they prefer to avoid to speak about vaccination. So the decision process, in fact, when the Prime Minister and the actual Minister of Health announced in July that the 11 vaccination would be mandatory in next year. It's not just the position of the new government, but the process started several years ago, and different reports and action plan were conducted between 2012 and 2017. And there are some progress and some actions as a midwife who are able to vaccine now children and women, things like that. Nurses also are allowed to vaccine against flu without a prescription for all people. In 2015, Senator's Ural report conclude that an action plan for a new vaccination policy and a public debate about vaccination were necessary. And in January 2016, Mrs. Touraine announced that organization of a citizen consultation with an orientation committee. The citizen concertation lasted 6 months between April and November 2016 with two juries, one of citizens and one of health professionals. One online participative platform was set up with more than 10,000 participations. We conduct opinion surveys, qualitative and quantitative studies. 45 personalities were interviews, even anti-vaccine movements, with two questions: how to improve confidence and how to improve vaccine coverage. That is the result of the summary of a qualitative study. More than 100 people were interviewed in different groups of people, parents, elderly, young people, ecology, people with a way of life, alternative medicine, and different groups. A lot of people for qualitative study. And the conclusion could be the same: very low level of knowledge about vaccine. To be mandatory or not is the most important criteria of the perception of vaccination. Beliefs about vaccination are deeply rooted in France in accordance with mandatory or not mandatory vaccination. When vaccination is compulsory, it means for people that they delegate the decision to vaccinate and they do not have to answer questions by themselves. And if it's recommended, they have to ask themselves many questions, and they don't know exactly what to do. Most people interviewed in this qualitative study did not want abolition of the law. They considered that if the state, the government, suppressed mandatory vaccination, they leave them alone, and the government want to make economies to save money, and it could be inequalities, especially for people who have difficulties to get information. The doctor is very important. Trusting the doctor is the key, and the doctor attitudes is another key of the decision. Distrust among population and healthcare worker is increasing. 40% of the population declare that they have doubts about vaccination security, is Eddie Larson study among 65 countries. But we saw the same data in a survey, the same survey done in Canada, US and France in 2004, and in another study, French study in 2011, we have the same data. In case of suppression of compulsory DTP, vaccination for DTP, more than 15% of GPs would not insist on importance of vaccination. 13% of parents would not vaccinate their children with DPT if this vaccine were no longer mandatory, especially among disadvantaged parents, more than 14%, and that is significant. And parents who look for information on the internet are more susceptible to be less favorable to vaccination and more inclined to not vaccinate their children against DPT if this vaccine were no longer compulsory. That is 21% for people looking only on internet. And only 8% people who ask their doctor. So the citizen consultation recommendation was necessary to build a vaccination plan with two goals: individuals and collective protection. Infants, pregnant women, elderly, people with chronic disease, a strong and long-term commitment of the state and health authorities, suppression of the coexistence of compulsory and recommended vaccines, with two propositions, either suppression of compulsory vaccines or extension of compulsory vaccines for a limited period, with or without exemption. Requirement at daycare center, kindergarten, and at school, with several conditions: transparency, information, listening and communication, official website, education and training for health professionals for more commitment, education at school, research, simplification in the vaccine pass, vaccine record, vaccine available, accessibility, free of charge, compensation for damage due to side effects, that is the case for DT polio, and action plan at regional level. Constitutional Council has confirmed that these obligations, DT polio, are conformed to the Constitution. But in February 2017, the Council of State considered that the minister has to make these vaccines, DT polio, available and ask her to do it in a time limit of 6 months, except if the law is extended the number of compulsory vaccinations. So the government had to take very quick decision before 8th of August. That's why in July the minister announced the the law project which will be discussed at the end of the next month, so at the end of October on the Parliament, and will begin probably at the beginning of 18. Thank you for your attention. That is the website we have set up 6 months ago, and for the public, the general public, and we are constructing another one for the health professional. Thank you.